as I can.
How long was it that you were working on the script and the story for Edinburgh? Was it something that you lived with for a long time?
Not specifically as a story, I guess as a preoccupation of mine on what kind of film I would do back in my own country.
Questo che è un cosmo? La testa mafis?
So, you know, when I went back to Greece after 10 years of being in the States, it was important to me to find a story that was that at least represented Greece for me. And I think a story like the relationship between father and daughter is a very Greek story that goes back to Greek tragedy and, you know, our narrative structures as a people, but it's also a universal story. And I wanted to make a buddy movie, you know, a buddy movie between a father and a daughter, which is something that you rarely see in cinema, and to create a female character who is strange, but at the same time, she's very strong in terms of the decisions that she makes.
We have Vageli Moriki here at the festival. And can you say a few words about him and your two female protagonists just as actors, and how it was that you wanted to work with them?
It was very difficult to cast for the part of Marina. I saw about 600 girls. Lots of them were actually non-actors. We did lots of street casting because I was interested in a kind of acting that was not theatrical, and it was not dramatic. And I finally went for a girl who basically did not speak Greek. You know, Ariane is French, but she had a very, very pure and direct approach to her part. I think the toughest was to cast for the father, because he was supposed to be a great father, but at the same time, an unconventional father. The thing about Vangeli is that he usually plays very different parts. And I really like that, you know, to cast someone who usually plays tough guys in a part where he's basically, you know, a sweetheart and someone who is weak, you know, and someone who is bitter, and he's desperately trying to leave something behind for his daughter.
When you see the film today, I don't know if at the festivals you have a chance to see it, if you choose to see it, which are the things that you like seeing now?
In fact, once I finish a film, I don't like watching it again. You know, it's as if it's something that it's for others to consume, to judge, to hate, to like. I'm usually very critical and very difficult with my stuff. So, I don't know. I mean, I mean, when I watched it for the first time, and in a way for the last time in Venice during our premiere last year, and, you know, I was surrounded by all of the team that made the movie, because we all went there together. It was you know, I felt this sense of achievement also because it was something that we all made together with great difficulty.
In your work as a producer, I mean, Dogtooth, Edinburgh, and now Alps, these are films that we're hearing a lot about, you know, in New York. It's nice, you know, we have the crisis and we hear all sorts of bad news from Greece, but then at the same time, there's this stuff happening with these three Greek films and a few more Greek films too. And I was curious how you feel about being on stage, kind of representing Greece at a time like this.
I think it's too easy to generalize Greek cinema into the so-called Greek New Wave. I don't think there is. I think there is a momentum, and I think that for the first time after a very long time, there is an urgency and an immediacy in making cinema. And I guess if there is any kind of wave, I would call it more like a force, a need for, you know, because a wave needs some kind of duration and some kind of quantity and some kind of maybe a common thread. And it's too early, I'm just very happy that I'm part of a very, very alive and very aggressive team of filmmakers. Now, about Greece, I mean, no one really knows how to speak about Greece. No one. You know, it's complete chaos. The name of our production company is House Film. So, you know, there is a symmetry there. And I think part of our job as filmmakers is observing, documenting, and trying to figure out what's going on, but not necessarily give answers. You know, I think it's more about creating more questions and keeping all of us alive. Because the only thing that I can say is that it's the first time in my life that I see Greece so awaken. You know, because now it's a matter of life or death. It's a matter of dignity, of pride, of what we're going to do with our children. And it's not just for Greece. You know, I think it's wrong to... Greece was a trigger, but, you know, it's happening everywhere. So, you know, I mean, yesterday the entire downtown was burned down. Coming back home from our office, it's as if we, you know, we crossed a war zone. And there's something really real about that. You know, that we have to all reckon with and just keep asking questions about how we got here and how we can get back up and how we can raise our children and make movies and make art and, you know, create public life in a way that's not a big lie, a big bubble and a big Byzantine corruption scheme.
And you are working on your next script, or you're already shooting for the next project?
No, it's... I wish, I mean, but basically we just finished Alps and we're completely bankrupt, beyond bankrupt. But yeah, I am working on the next film and hopefully I'll be able to somehow get it together. I'm not sure right now, but hopefully, you know, through all this energy that I'm talking about.
Θα έχει σκεφτεί όλα.